students, today in this video I am going to discuss with you chapter 14 commercial arithmetics. Okay, in this chapter first of all we will discuss unary method. So in this method we take an example. Suppose the cost of 18 grams is rupees 54. You have to find the cost of 24 pence. You are given the cost of 84 pence, and you have to find the cost of 24 pence. For this, you will have to find the cost of 1 pen first. The cost of 1 pen. That will be rupees 54 divided by 18. Okay, if you divide 54 by 18, you get rupees 3 because 83 is a 54. Now you have to find the cost of 24 pence. Okay, so now you will multiply this number by 24. That means 24 into 3. That means rupees 72. If we multiply 24 by 3, we get 72. One method is this. First we will divide to find the cost of 1 pen. Then if we have to find the cost of more than 1 pence, the next step is of multiplication. Other method is we can do 54 divided 18 multiply 24. In this way we can find. Okay, here we write 54 divided 18, and here in the next step 54 by 18 into 24. We can cut the numerator with the denominator. Okay, we can cut these numbers, these two numbers, and we can also cut these two numbers. Okay, so 18 is a 54. We have to check which number we can cancel. Okay, 18 is a 54. Now these two numerators are left, these two numbers are left. We will multiply these two numbers. 24 is a 72, and we get the answer to this 72. Okay, students. So the next topic is
answer rupees 62. So which is better D
cheap deal. So that is, this is 65, this is 62. So 62 is means second deal. Answer is second deal is better. Okay, is it clear? So the next topic I'm going to discuss. Means 25. by 10. We have this number to convert it into percentage. We will multiply it by 100. So we got this 25 times up to 50%. Okay, we get this answer. Next, if we have to find 60% of 500, we have to find if you got 60% marks out of 500, that means how many marks you get? 500 into 60, we will multiply these two numbers and percent means over 100. Okay, this is cut with this. Okay, we are left with 60 and 5, 60 times up 300. If any student gets 60% marks out of 500, means he is getting 300 marks. Okay. So next is the topic 5. Suppose in a class of 50 students, 90% students passed. You have to find how many students failed. Okay. Okay. Answer is total students in the class 50. Number of students passed. 90% of 50. That means 50, we will multiply these two numbers, 50 multiply 90 divided by 104%. Okay. We can cancel it this way. Okay. We are left with 5 and 9. That is 5 times 45. So 45 students out of 50 passed. Now how many failed? Number of students failed. So 50 minus 45. So how many students are failed? 5. Okay. Is it clear, students? Okay.